Hi, today I'm going to talk about digital transformation from an Australian perspective. So those who have seen Gartner report, which was published in Q1 2019, it clearly states that only 8% of Australian enterprises are getting results from their digital transformation activities. And one of the key reasons which was cited in the report is that somewhere ambition surpasses performance in transformation activities. Now, when it comes to digital transformation, which is tightly coupled with your business transformation, scale is the acid test, because the reason you are doing digital transformation is to scale your business. Now, only 7% of Australian companies fit the description where they have finished their assessments, strategic analysis and planning and design, and then they are moving to the later phases of the implementation. And some of them are still working through the first two phases, which are strategy and planning. That includes assessment. And some are actually losing behind to those who are in the similar business from the competitive advantage perspective. And they will have hard time to scale their business in future. The other challenge that we have experienced after talking to so many customers is that they have application portfolio, but they are not able to map it to the end state. End state that, okay, you have these applications in your data center. Now you take it to the cloud. Okay, what is next? Okay, once the migration or infrastructure upgrade is done, what is the next state you want to achieve? And that's another gap, because if you use the same application that you are using on-premises in your cloud environment, how is it going to scale your business, right? That's another big question that we are helping organizations address. So the next state is more of a platform state. So you move your applications or your data from on-premises to cloud, and then you go to the platform state. And we are actually talking about four different platform business models. So we don't just call it platforms or platform models, we call it platform business models. So one is collaboration model, the other one is orchestration model, the third one is creation model, and the fourth one is matching model. Collaboration model actually amplifies existing relationships in a business ecosystem, and the orchestration model enables different components to be brought to deliver combined value from the business capability perspective. Then the creation model, it allows participants to build new value based on building blocks and infrastructure provided by the platform. Now the matching model actually matches the supply demand or providers with the consumers. So it is more of sitting at the intersection of demand and supply, just like consumers of Alibaba, consumers of Uber, consumers of Amazon. So these are the four different types of platform business models. That's where I guess most of the architects should look at it and map their application. So they should be able to define the end state, and they should be able to define a schedule, okay, by when this will be done, so that the business folks should be able to plan to expand their business, or if they want to expand consumers on the existing platform, the end users or the consumers should not face any challenge in accessing it. There should not be any performance issue, there should not be any quality issue, there should not be any scale up, scale out issue, and so on and so forth. Now, the other thing that we have experienced after talking to the customers, what sort of challenge there, everybody knows cultural challenge. That's one of the key areas that organizations are focusing, but we call it digital dexterity programs. So the organizations have to introduce digital dexterity programs where they have to improve the organization's skill and culture. So just by implementing digital workplace technology, it's not going to help in terms of digital transformation. Somewhere they have to do this or come up with these digital dexterity programs or digital dexterity programs to train their workforce and improve the overall skills and culture, so that when it combines with the digital workplace technology, you get the right value out of their business. and the digital transformation programs, and that's where the rubber meets the road. Okay, so now from our perspective, how do we help customers? We don't engage with the customers in a way the other organizations are doing it. We have come up with a very different business model where you don't have to pay for 6 months or 2 months, or you write a big contract. You have to pay as you go, simple. So software architecture as a service, solution architecture as a service, enterprise architecture as a service. So these are the services we have. You choose one of the services and pay as you go model. So you don't even have to pay for the day. You just have to pay for the amount of work that is being delivered by that service. And that's why, the reason we have come up with this model, so that we don't put a lot of cost pressures on you, because you already have enough cost pressures on your organization to deliver these digital transformation programs. And using these services, which are pay as you go model, is going to expedite your programs, going to deliver the architectural artifacts right on time, and the exact deliverables that are mapped to your project and right on time, so that you can finish your digital transformation journey on time. I guess this is it from my side. I'll definitely cover one more video talking about other services as well, from the data platform perspective, from the AI platform perspective, and the disease platform that we have. So data platform, there are several articles which we are going to publish, and we have published some videos as well. So Rahu is our data platform, and that's how we named it. Our AI platform is named as Ketu. So, and the third one is disease prediction platform. We will come up with the name very soon. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. Have a great evening, whichever part of the world you are in. Thank you very much. Great day. Bye.